The Out of Bounds Show podcast is brought to you by Live Oaks Golf Club and Roosevelt's at Live Oaks. Whether you're in the mood for a hot lunch or you want to go play a quick 18 with a cold beer, the only choice is Live Oaks Golf Club and Roosevelt at Live Oaks on Highway 49 North.
WRKS Pickens Jackson.
Are you ready?
Yes!
From the Whiskey 61 Lounge inside the Bank Plus Studio.
You are listening to
Mississippi's number one sports talk show, The Out of Bounds Show with Bo Bounds.
Streaming worldwide live on the Out of Bounds radio app and on your radio
at ESPN 105.9. The Soul.
All right. All the sports injuries that we discussed are powered by, Mississippi Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Center. Welcome in. Good morning. Out of Bounds, 105.9 The Zone. We have an update here. Speaking of Mississippi Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Center, Tiger Woods recovering from surgery at a Los Angeles hospital early Wednesday after surgeons placed a rod in his lower right leg and screws and pins in his foot and ankle. The legendary golfer suffered significant orthopedic injuries to his right lower extremity following his devastating SUV crash outside of Los Angeles earlier in the day. According to Harbor UCLA Medical Center's chief medical officer, that's a mouthful, Dr. Anish Mahan. Woods, 45, sustained open fractures affecting both the upper and lower portions of the tibia and fibula, according to Dr. Mahan. Surgeon stabilized Woods' leg bones by inserting a rod into the tibia. We'll have to get Dr. Jason Kraft or someone from Mississippi Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Center to walk us through some of this. We also wanted to visit with them about Dak. And you mentioned another injury, Blake. I can't remember what it was.
Joe Burrow.
Thank you. Yes, that's what I reached out on.
He had a weird injury.
He did. So we'll cover a lot of that here in the next week, as we'll have one of the orthopedic surgeons on from Mississippi Sports Medicine. The Out of Bounds Show is brought to you by the Ribeye and bacon-wrapped shrimp at Kessler Prime in the Renaissance. Visit KesslerPrime.com to make a reservation. Yes, they do have barbecue shrimp and homemade hot tamales as appetizers. Blake feels like I should be taking him somewhere this week, Kessler Prime or somewhere, because last week, while Blake spent 26 hours on the road to basically get just a little past Freeport and back and did not get to the College Baseball Showdown because of the weather and the trucks and ice on the road, he had a Snickers, he said, and something else.
Some chips.
Snickers and some chips while sleeping in the car on Friday night / Saturday morning before they turned around and didn't even get back till 4:30. He did go to a Chili's, and he thought it was like eating at some kind of five-star restaurant in New York. But Blake feels like because I went and got a to-go order from Kessler Prime on Friday night that I should take him to dinner. I'd like your reaction to that on the Mississippi Ag John Deere Tractor text line, 601-885-3776. Do you agree or disagree that I should take Blake to dinner tonight or tomorrow night? I can't wait to hear about that. We're giving away two rounds of golf to Live Oaks Golf Club. Give us your best Tiger moment. Just shoot us a text, 601-885-3776. Or your most memorable Tiger Woods moment. We're all glad that he's okay. And he was going to play golf with Drew Brees and Justin Herbert, Blake?
Yes, so he was doing...
Or do an appearance?
Yeah, he was doing something for the Golf Discovery Channel, whatever, some content shoot where... On Monday, he was with Dwayne Wade and David Spade giving lessons, quote-unquote. So he can't even swing. He had just had his fifth back surgery. Can't even swing a club. So he was out there kind of just in the cart giving lessons as a coach, whatever. It's for content, for video, that type of thing. So all that went well Monday, and then he was on the way to do the same thing with Justin Herbert and Drew Brees, and obviously that did not happen.
Wow.
And you and I mentioned, kind of interestingly...
So he was able to play a little bit in December because we saw the footage of he and his son playing in the PGA father-son, but I guess something just was not right back there, and he had to go under the knife again?
Yeah, like a week or so ago, or 2 weeks ago, okay. Something like that.
Okay,
Good Lord. Interestingly enough, as you and I mentioned, this is not where he lives. He's in town only for like 3 days for a shoot. I thought it was interesting that he was driving himself. Like, you would think he'd be kind of set up and that they'd just be like, hey, we're going to pick you up, take you here, drop you back off, whatever. Right. You know, that's kind of what you do when you're that level of person and you're in a town that's... If this was near his house, it would make sense that he was driving. Thought it was interesting that he was driving, being that he was only there for like 2.5 days, 3 days, yeah. Something like that.
No, I you and I discussed that before the show. And he was in a Hyundai SUV.
Right? Yeah, the Genesis. The Genesis.
Or did you say Hyundai or Kia?
Well, Genesis is owned by Hyundai. No, oh, Genesis okay. is owned by... Genesis is the luxury brand of Hyundai.
No kidding.
That's yes. And this is their only SUV. So he was at Sunday. Everybody saw him on TV for the PGA Tour event,
right.
Which was the Genesis Invitational. Gotcha. This is all this is wrapped up together.
I watched some of that on TV this
Correct.
Weekend.
So he was driving this Genesis GV80 or something like that, their only SUV. And that's what happened. Now, you could say the safety and quality of the Genesis is the only reason he's still alive, because even though he did flip it, it definitely saved his life.
Right.
10 airbags, they said. Yeah, Genesis has already put out a statement.
Isn't that
obviously.
Incredible?
Yeah.
I mean, the safety in vehicles today and cars, unbelievable. Wow. Okay. So Tiger Woods is okay. Ole Miss won in basketball last night, Blake, at Missouri.
A ranked... What is it with Ole Miss? They can beat these ranked teams and then they lose to like chum teams like Mississippi State? Makes no sense.
Well, evidently Kermit's got Missouri's number because they just beat him at home like mm-hmm. 2 weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
And then they went on the road and won last night. It was a competitive ball game and a close one. And bottom line is, you know, Ole Miss made a couple of really nice offensive plays late in the game, but really stops. Stops and loose balls. That's something about Kermit Davis Jr., man. Those kids play. And they play hard. I mean, he just demands. He is a very, all of them are demanding, but there are some different levels of demands. And Kermit Davis Jr. and the Ole Miss Rebels get another W. So now they're back, I would think, on the bubble. I mean, who knows? They could close this thing out. Enough teams could not play. You may make it in.
Yeah.
You may make it interesting.
Just need to keep winning. Just, I mean, the state game is what it is. Just win a few more games. You'll be all right.
Yeah.
You'll be in.
Yeah. We'll have Mike Bianco on at 8:30. No, 8:40. You told me closer to 8:40 coming out of a team coaches meeting.
Yeah. 8:35, somewhere in that
okay.
range. Yeah.
All right. So it may be closer to 8:35, 8:40 on Coach Bianco just here in about 30 minutes or so.
A lot of priority when you're number one team in the country.
Yeah, you know, got a game today,
people
right?
want you. Yeah, 4 o'clock, both teams, 4 p.m.
Arkansas State, Ole Miss Rebels.
In Oxford?
In Oxford.
Correct.
Okay. Some of you asked about the Thomas Dobbs interview where I talked about how Thomas Dobbs is, what is he, Blake, like the head health official?
Head of the Mississippi Department
okay.
of Health, something like that.
Nobody knew who he was prior to COVID, and he's having his 15 minutes of fame and very much enjoying it. We requested an interview with Dr. Dobbs, and we got turned down. So I just wanted to let you know that we did send that in. You know, maybe we'll hear from him at some point. I do believe, I think that you should raise hell with your state representatives and state senators and anybody else that you want to email. There's no question we should be at 100% capacity for college baseball. People are packed into Home Depot, Kroger, Lowe's, and are flying on Delta and American Airlines right now. Now, if you don't feel comfortable, you should stay away from an event like that, okay? And I get that. That's your prerogative, and you can decide. But it is time to open it up. the 25% is absolutely and totally ridiculous. And it should be your choice as to whether you want to go to an event like that. We need to be 100% capacity for college baseball. Welcome and good morning. 105.9 The Zone, ESPN, WRKS. All right. Mike Bianco will join us. We're not sure. 8:30, 8:35, 8:40, depending on a coach's meeting. Looking forward to visiting with Coach Mike Bianco. They're 3-0. They play today against Arkansas State. Are they like the Red Wolves or something?
I believe that's accurate.
Okay. Is Tommy Raffo still the head baseball coach there?
Let's find out.
That's been like 13 years? I don't know. Raffo was a first baseman at Mississippi State. And a really good one at that, for that matter. He was on the 1990 CWS team. He was the starting first baseman. Guess who else started on that team? John Cohen, among others. But anyway, Cohen ended up getting the job over Raffo back in 08, somewhere in there. That was Greg Burns' kind of first hire type deal. They hired him away from Kentucky, if you remember. John had won the SEC, their first and only SEC championship at Kentucky in baseball. Blake?
Yes, Raffo is the head coach of the Arkansas State Red Wolves.
All right, so Mississippi State alum will be in Oxford today, Arkansas State and Ole Miss. Mike Bianco will join us in 15 or 20 minutes on the Shinerbach guest line. I just decided to pick up some Shinerbach last Friday, and I had not had one in a while, and you just forget how delicious a beer that is. It is phenomenal. It's also a great beer to cook with.
That is accurate.
It's a darker beer, but it's not heavy. It's not, you know, it's not the deal where you drink one, you're like, oh, gosh. Of course, Guinness doesn't do that to me either, which is another great beer, by the way, and a great beer to cook with. But Shinerbach guest line, Mike Bianco. Then Matt Janella, golf insider. He's with the Golf Channel for a decade. He's now out in San Diego. Matt Janella will talk Tiger Woods, 9 a.m. 9:30 today, John Talty, AL.com. On War Damn Eagle and Roll Tide. Welcome in. Good morning. Ole Miss with a good win over, a really good win over Missouri last night. Made some great stops. But I look at loose balls, and I know it sounds corny and we eye roll it because coaches preach it all the time, but hustle plays, who wants it more and all that, you know, dorky stuff, it matters. And Ole Miss, you know, they're interesting the way they're built, but they've got some athletes. They may not have the height that you want down low. They got some dudes that can run and jump around, though. So Ole Miss with another win. We'll see what Kermit Davis Jr. does the next 2.5 weeks. I'm in. I mean, I'm already excited about March Madness because it's awesome and it's sports and it's, you know, winner in advance, loser go home, and Americans can get right behind that. We get into that. We got it. All right, you win this game, you play again. In 2 days, you lose, it's over. And it's wide open. And I know we say that every now and then. I'm serious. It is wide open. There's not a, you know, a dominant team, so to speak, in college basketball, although Michigan looks good. And, of course, Gonzaga's up there and some other teams. All right. Live in the Bank Plus studio, Out of Bounds. 105.9 The Zone, ESPN. I hope that you will reach out to your state representative and state senator and whoever else. And you got to do. You can complain on Twitter or you can spend 30 seconds to send an email. Those matter. They want to get reelected. We're talking about the college baseball. The capacity right now is 25%. That's absolute and total nonsense. People all over the country jumped on planes this morning, on packed planes. American Airlines, Delta Airlines, and so on. It needs to be your choice. What has happened is they have really, really enjoyed making decisions for us since last March. If you ever question whether government could solve a big problem, we've got our case study that will be studied for years and years and years. Hell no, they can't. We talk about bureaucratic incompetence all the time, and it is alive and well. But it needs to be 100%. Capacity in Starkville and Oxford for many reasons. One, what we know. about COVID. Two, Lowe's, Home Depot, Whole Foods,
Kroger,
Corner Market, Publix,
restaurants,
Delta Airlines, American Airlines, and so on have been packed. By the way, we received texts throughout. This is even when people were in freakout mode. Now, we knew by April, you know, that this wasn't going to be the apocalypse, but the left and the West and East Coast media ran with it to scare the hell out of everybody and crush their economies, too, in New York and California, among other states, which was all self-inflicted, had nothing to do with the virus. But we need to be 100% capacity in college baseball, and we need our college towns to have that, Blake, boost or influx of money, economic development, tourism. You want to go to Oxford and Starkville. You want to enjoy a Dr. Pepper and some peanuts with your son or daughter, some nachos, a cold beer out in the outfield, you know, ribs, pork tenderloin, a big old cheeseburger in the left field lounge, whatever it is. And it's time to open it up, but you're going to have to put some pressure on some people. It needs to go to 50% by this weekend, easily, but again, it should be 100% by SEC play. This is absolutely and totally ridiculous. You should be furious, but you've got to send emails. They need to be professional.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, these are public officials. Many of them are really good people and good community, you know, civil servants. But it's time to rip the Band-Aid off and rock and roll. Lowe's never shut down, Home Depot, Walmart, Kroger, Publix, you know. And again, people were flying and texting us in March, April, and May. And many of you have already flown. I have. We're flying again in a week and a half or so. And but it needs to be your choice. And if you don't feel comfortable, then by all means, I don't want you to go. But that, I don't know I don't know your deal. So, but we need to open it up 100% college baseball today. And these officials need to, you know, this is kind of it's gone to dictatorship type stuff. All right.
If you don't professionally and quickly do what we're talking about now, then we're going to come to regional and super regional time and still be prohibited from having our stadiums filled. And that's going to be an unfortunate day.
Some people never stopped playing travel ball, softball, or baseball, and parks around the country were packed even in last April, May, June, July. And there were no, you know, we keep hearing, again, the elitist media wants to tell you about super spreader events. They got all over the kids in Tuscaloosa after the national championship game. Didn't happen. They were dying for a super spreader event in Tampa after the whole city. And that's a metro, you know, Tampa is, you know, bleeds out in all these other communities that are packed full of people. And there was a lot of celebrating and people going out to restaurants and bars and so on. It was not a super spreader event. I know CNN is dying for a super spreader event, but it wasn't. The Tuscaloosa celebration after Bama beat, did they beat Clemson?
Yeah.
Yeah. It was not a super spreader. Ohio State. It was not a super spreader event. So we need college baseball to be opened up now, but you're going to have to demand it, but you're going to have to send some emails and make some people. Everybody scared to death in any kind of higher ed public office space because of the fear-mongering, life-shaming, mass-shaming, social distancing-shaming, all that has gone on. All they've wanted to do is talk down to you about 40 to 42 states out of the 50, and enough's enough. So it's time to rock and roll, open this thing up, and we need a packed Duty Noble Field in Oxford University Stadium for SEC baseball. But needs to be this weekend. And Thomas Dobbs denied our interview request, declined to jump on the show. So that's where we are. Out of Bounds, ESPN 105.9 The Zone is brought to you by Ace Bolt and Screw, powered by DeWalt Tools. Ace Bolt and Screw, powered by DeWalt Tools. New location, Gluckstadt, Madison County. AceBolt.net. Go there right now. AceBolt.net. Ace Bolt and Screw, powered by DeWalt Tools. Mike Bianco coming up in, we think, about 10 minutes. Mike Bianco, head baseball coach at Ole Miss, in about 10 minutes on the Shiner Bach guest line.
Press the button, my friend.
The Out of Bounds Show is live from the Whiskey 61 Lounge in the Bank Plus Studio.
Check it out.
All right, we should have Coach Mike Bianco coming up here in the next few minutes. Ole Miss is number one in several polls, 3-0 after the weekend. They beat Texas, TCU, and Texas Tech. Played great baseball to get the season kicked off. The SEC was 8-1 in the tournament. Arkansas was also undefeated in the tournament, and Mississippi State went 2-1. Ole Miss will play Arkansas State today in Oxford. We should start like a hashtag, Blake. Open it up or something.
There you go.
Hopefully we'll get to 100% capacity. Well, we need to get to 50 now and move towards 100% capacity in college baseball, or SEC baseball for that matter, sooner than later. Welcome in. Good morning. ESPN 105.9 The Zone. ESPN 105.9 The Zone, WRKS. We're streaming live on the Out of Bounds radio app. We'd love for you to download that. Blake, we rolling the cameras?
We are.
Man, am I looking good in this New Orleans Saints hat or what? Oh, you hate the Saints.
No comment.
That's why I wear it. If you want to watch the show right now, bam, YouTube. YouTube app or YouTube.com, search Out of Bounds Sports, and you can see the set here. Got a little Auburn, Ole Miss, Mississippi State, Southern Miss, LSU, and A&M on the set. And a super cool Lane Kiffin bobblehead doll that Pear Orchard was so kind to give us. And then a Four Roses bourbon single barrel bottle. A little Jonesy Q action. Hey, I want to let you know that you pit masters, grill masters, you know, you want to upgrade or you're low on seasoning and shake. If you'll go to jonesyq.com, order some of the rubs and sauces, award-winning by Jeff Jones. Anything $20 and over, free shipping. Promo code OOBSHOW. That's jonesyq.com. I mean, look, they've got the Love Rub, the Money Honey, right? The Gold Digger, Bone Rub, Ecstasy, which is amazing. To me, the Ecstasy and the Love Rub are kind of his all-purpose seasonings. But I like to combine a lot of them, and I've told you about Love Rub and Money Honey is great. Blake, you did some fried fish. Money honey?
I think I did. I think it was money. I have two of them that are like that brown rub, and I honestly don't remember which one I grabbed. I think it was money honey.
I have a money honey right here.
Yeah, I use them. I use all of them. I mean, I have a bunch of them. Like you said, the Ecstasy is kind of like a Delta version of Tony Sachery's or a seasoned salt. You know, it's an all-purpose. You can use it on anything. But I went with the money honey and a little Tabasco, little bread, Ritz cracker breading, fried fish. It was good.
Okay.
It's good, man.
Chef Blake.
Tasty.
With some money honey on the fried fish. Did you do it in the cast iron?
Yes, because I don't have an air fryer or anything like that, so I oil fry, pan
fry. Okay. All right.
Yes, sir.
You're an animal.
It was delicious.
You know what? You're an animal in the kitchen.
Thank you.
Yes.
I'll do what I can.
All right. The Mississippi Ag John Deere Tractor text line is 601-885-3776, brought to you by Mississippi Ag's two locations in the metro area, Canton and Pearl. Mississippi Ag, John Deere, America's tractor for your farmland, family land, hunting camp, and so on. Mississippi Ag, agup.com to find a retail location nearest you. Tiger Woods is, I guess, starting to recover from leg and ankle injuries. That looks pretty bad from that New York Post article that I just read some of for you in the last segment. Whenever I hear, you know, a rod in the leg. Yeah. So could be a long recovery. Hopefully he'll just be able to play casual golf like we were talking about with his kids. Dan Wetzel has a great article, Yahoo Sports, on the crash comes just as Tiger Woods was really enjoying playing golf with his kids. And the title of the article by Dan Wetzel, Yahoo Sports, is "Here's Hoping Tiger Woods Can Return to His Golf Dad Life." Blake, do you know who Mississippi State plays in basketball?
They play at home against South Carolina.
Is it tonight or tomorrow night?
Tonight.
Okay.
Today's Wednesday,
Frank
right?
Frank Martin?
Yeah. I believe that's accurate.
Okay.
Pull up that schedule again. Yeah. But yeah.
Did I tell you I was in a line with him at Starbucks at the Sandestin Hilton last year?
You did.
Okay. Yeah. He's a big man.
Yeah, South Carolina at Mississippi State, 6 o'clock on the SEC Network. How many people, Bo, do you think, will there be more people watching the SEC Network Plus broadcast of a Jackson State-Mississippi State baseball game or watching State versus South Carolina on actual TV in basketball?
Baseball.
I agree. Isn't that remarkable?
I don't know what it is like today. Yeah. Yeah. I'm going with that. I'm going with that.
State fans are checked out on Howland and the Bulldogs.
Well, you are. I mean, you get kind of grumpy and angry
they're garbage.
When you start to...
They're garbage.
Like, it's not just for you apathy. Something else has set in for you. There's some resentment that you have, I think.
Because there's a refusal to change or learn or grow.
Yeah.
I'm proud of you for going to 3 Final Fours 15 years ago. Do something in the last decade. I mean, seriously, there's been zero adept in 6 years. He's not learned one offensive play or done one thing differently offensively. It's a waste of talent.
Well, I don't think they're going to change on the offensive end or embrace analytics either. But I think that's most of college basketball coaches. I mean, I think most of them are kind of archaic and dinosaurian because, you know, the game's sometimes a struggle. I'm excited about March Madness, but sometimes it is a little bit of a struggle to watch. But last night was a big win for the Ole Miss Rebels over the Missouri Tigers. That's a sweep, by the way, for Kermit Davis Jr. Hey, want to let you know that we'll have Matt Janella at 9 a.m. He was with the Golf Channel for a decade, and he will join us at 9 a.m. to talk Tiger Woods. You're listening to the Out of Bounds Show, ESPN 105.9 The Zone. Driven by your next John Deere tractor at Mississippi Ag, 16 locations in Mississippi and Arkansas. Mississippi Ag, John Deere, America's tractor. We want to welcome in Mike Bianco, the head baseball coach at Ole Miss. They are number one in the country, coming off 3 wins out in the College Baseball Showdown, 3 top 10 wins against TCU, Texas Tech, and Texas. Coach, good morning. Welcome in.
Good morning, Bo. How are you?
Man, I'm doing great. How about this past weekend? After almost a year off, your squad, no warm-up games. You're thrown into some big-time play in a big-time tournament, and y'all come out of there with 3 wins.
Yeah, I think the word that comes to mind is, you know, just proud. You know, as you know, here in Mississippi and north of you in North Mississippi, you know, last week, you know, we were in the midst of a snow and ice storm and weren't really sure if we were even going to be able to get out there. And then once you get out there, you know, Texas had been hit with it, you know, the day before us, you know, 2 different times. And, you know, with all the power outages and, you know, water and displaced families, we weren't sure if they were going to allow us to come. So, you know, with all of those obstacles, you know, on top of the pandemic and not being out on the field for nearly a year, and then, as you mentioned, to be able to play in a major league stadium against 3 top 10 teams, you know, how would we respond? And our guys were terrific. We were far from perfect, but we played really well. It's hard to expect, you know, much more than, you know, what they gave us. But just proud of the way we played and, you know, to get through the weekend.
Was it a little emotional for y'all just because, you know, you missed out on so many games last year and you hadn't played in a long time, and you mentioned all the lead up with the storms and everything else. Was it a little butterflies and emotional on Saturday?
No, I don't think emotional, probably would be the the best term. I think, you know, from our standpoint, you know, from the coach's standpoint, I think there was butterflies. You know, how would we handle all of this? You know, the first weekend, and normally you're not playing that type of competition, especially on the road, and then all the obstacles leading up to it. I think maybe some frustration, you know, where, you know, if you would have told me the first weekend, you know, you're going to get, you know, snowed in, you know, you're not going to play because of, you know, COVID or some other reason, you know, I think, you know, it was more frustrating, but I think that's why I was proud of our guys. I mean, if you looked at our players and the way we reacted, the way the kids handled themselves from the time we stepped on the bus to the time we got there, or even leading up to it, you know, all the practices indoors. I mean, we hadn't taken batting practice outside in almost a week, you know, prior to the tournament. And so just the way our guys handled it, just really proud of them.
How about Jacob Gonzalez? I mean, we know about him in the field, but and look, he made some spectacular plays, but also what he did for your club at the plate, Coach.
Yeah, and, you know, to be honest with you, when he got here, we knew he was a terrific player, and we knew he was a terrific offensive player, but he's a physical shortstop, you know, much different than Anthony Servidio, more out of the Gray Kessinger mold, you know, 6'2", you know, 190-pound, you know, just really good athlete. And we weren't sure, you know, defensively, you know, would he stay at short? Would we have to put him, you know, at third base or move him to a corner outfield position? But, you know, just terrific defensively, as we saw very quickly. Mm. And then, you know, as the fall progressed, you just knew that, you know, he was going to be a middle of the lineup type of guy for us.
Yeah, what a weekend for him. Coach Mike Bianco, 3-0. They'll play Arkansas State today at 4 o'clock in Oxford. He joins us on the Shinerbach guest line. They're ranked number one in the country. What about Derek Diamond? I mean, he's a third starter. He looks like the best third starter in the country. Walk us through his performance Monday to close out the tournament with your third win.
Well, yeah, as you mentioned, you know, he threw about as well as, you know, anybody could throw, you know, as number one and number two. But to do it on day three, where, you know, we needed that. We needed a shot in the arm. And, you know, I think we always talk about Energy Sunday, and the reason we use that phrase is, you know, a lot of the pomp and circumstances already taken out of the weekend. You know, that's the fourth day that you travel to the ballpark because you practice the first day, and then you come there day one, day two, day three. But, man, he was electric. I mean, he was up to 97 a couple times in the first inning and really pitched through the first five innings, really in that 92 to 95 range, just a dominant fastball, really good slider, and even finished up, I think, as he got, you know, tired there in the sixth inning with some exceptional changeups. And just, you know, we knew he'd be a good match for Texas just because he's a strike throwing machine, just really can command the ball with all three pitches. But we needed that. And I think just on the heels of a lot of publicity after the weekend, the first two wins, and the Baseball America coming out early Monday morning, ranking us number one. You know, I think a little more, you know, pressure, you know, to finish the weekend. And, mm-hmm. and boy, he didn't disappoint.
Coach Mike Bianco on the Out of Bounds Show and the Shinerbach guest line, 3-0 coming out of Texas. You're listening to ESPN 105.9 The Zone. Coach, you've been there and done that for years as a player and a coach, and you've been on the big stage and in big moments for a lot of the last 30 years in baseball as a player and coach. But every year you got a new group of guys. So how much do you talk about being number one, or do you mention it at all?
It's a great question. And, you know, when I woke up, you know, that morning, you know, Monday, you know, I wanted to, you know, think about, you know, how would I address it, or what would I say? And really, you know, it didn't take me long to say, well, you know, to myself, you know, why would I mention it? Why would I talk about it? You know, when we're ranked fifth or fourth, or, you know, in years past, if we were ranked as high as two or three, you know, I never talked about it. We didn't wear it, you know, as a badge of honor, or you don't get a trophy for it. And all the things that everybody knows, you know, it doesn't help you win a game. It doesn't help you prepare. It doesn't help you do anything. You know, it's nice to be recognized. I think anybody that says that, you know, is full of crap. I think it's, you know, you'd much rather be ranked than not ranked, because sure. that usually means you're doing pretty well, and you know people respect your team and what you've accomplished. But we also got to keep in perspective, and I think our players and everybody knows it's one poll, it's somebody's opinion, and if you don't win, if you don't play well, you don't have success, you won't be there the next week, right? And so, you know, take it for what it is. I don't think as far as the attention of it as far as to the team is any different than being ranked, you know, third or fifth or any of those things. Now, I will say, you know, from a program standpoint, from a fan standpoint, from a recruiting standpoint, those are all really good things. And so, to be honest with you, my approach was I didn't even mention it. You know, we went along with our business as normal in our meetings and didn't talk about it. Talked about Texas, talked about, you know, the game plan, talked about, you know, Energy Sunday, which would be Energy Monday, day three. We just did what we did and didn't even mention it.
Mike Bianco on the Out of Bounds Show. Peyton Chatagnier, how's his health, Coach?
He's going to be out for a couple weeks. You know, some people know, or you know, people that were following, he had a great weekend. He was co-SEC Player of the Week in Game 3 against Texas. I think he was 3-for-4 with 3 doubles. Really got us going early in the game, which we needed his spark. And later in the game, I think somewhere in the 7th inning, he hit a double in the left center gap, and running the second, he pulled his hamstring. And those can be tricky. And so certainly out for this week, and I would assume for at least a couple weeks, maybe longer. You know, sometimes you just can't tell with the hamstrings. They're worse than the ankles just because, you know, it's just harder to gauge. And, you know, and you can re-injure them very easily. And so not only is he a good hitter, but he's a good runner and he plays fast. And so we'll have to keep an eye on that. And then the other big loss for us is not just his offensive presence or defense, but man, he's such an emotional leader for us. He's a guy that brings so much energy, so much positive energy with that big smile. And you know, that's going to be missed as much as his bat.
Mike Bianco on the Out of Bounds Show, ESPN 105.9 The Zone. He joins us on the Shinerbach guest line. Coach, other than Gonzalez, I know there were several, but which newcomer also impressed you over the weekend?
Well, you know, I liked that we had some guys that, you know, came in, you know, out of the bullpen and threw the ball into the strike zone. And I know we talk about newcomers, but you got to remember some of the guys that were freshmen last year only played a couple of games, especially if you're a pitcher. You may have only had a couple outings, but I thought Trey LaFleur, who's not necessarily a newcomer, he was with us last year. He's a COVID freshman, if you will. But he got to start 3 games in a row at first base and got some big hits and some huge defensive plays at first base. And as you may know, Bo, he a couple weeks ago dislocated his shoulder at first base in an inter-squad game, and really probably up until about 3 days before we traveled to Texas, I didn't think he was coming. But he worked really hard with Josh Porter, our trainer, and got ready to play and had a really good weekend. Of course, in the first game, Jackson Kimbrell and Drew McDaniel. Drew will start today against Arkansas State. Both of those guys are COVID freshmen, so they were here last year but pitched very sparingly and were outstanding in that first win. You know, guy like thought Josh Mallett, who is a true freshman. Nice to see him in Game 3 go and fill up the strike zone. Brandon Johnson, I thought was outstanding. And so again, some guys you know, that stepped in and did a great job. We got a veteran club, a lot of guys that have been here in the past, but it's a good mix.
What was your one big takeaway from the new Texas Rangers ballpark, Coach?
Wow, good question. I think, you know, it was beautiful. Really, really neat to play, you know, in a stadium, not just a big league stadium, but a brand new big league stadium, and one that they played the World Series in, and could have picked any stadium in the country, but they picked that stadium. So that was kind of had a little different, you know, lure to it, if you will. But just how big, and really how many people were there? You know, they, We had 17,000 people for game two.
That's awesome.
For a college baseball game, during a pandemic, and social distance. So that'll tell you, that maybe not gives credit to the stadium, but it does give credit to college baseball in Texas and, what a neat event it was.
I love it. And Coach, we'll leave it at this. The SEC goes 8-1. In that showdown against three top 10 Big 12 teams? How about that?
Yep. Yeah, pretty impressive. Pretty impressive. It'll show you a little bit about our conference, huh?
Unbelievable. Wow. It's a marathon, not a sprint in this league, but it is the deepest and most talented by far. He is Coach Mike Bianco. Ole Miss is 3-0 coming off a monster weekend, and they'll play this afternoon against Arkansas State. Coach, thanks so much for your time today. We'll catch up again in a few weeks.
Always enjoy it. Thanks, Bob.
Thanks, Coach. Mike Bianco. Ole Miss is number one, 3-0, and they'll play Arkansas State this afternoon in Oxford. We're live in the Bank Plus studio. I hate that for Peyton Chatagnier. Golly, the guy's a talented baseball player. And you saw him come up running to second base, Blake, in the game against Texas on Monday. He'd already ripped three doubles. He'll be out for a little bit of time. He's a very, very talented dude. And you could tell how much Mike Bianco thinks of him. Jacob Gonzalez looks like a freak. Very, very talented guy. And Derek Diamond coming in as the third starter and dominating on a Monday. I thought Coach Bianco made a great point on that. Fourth day at the ballpark. Got to continue to do what you need to do and keep the main thing the main thing. And they had been named number one in one of the polls that morning. He decided not to address it. It worked out. He's got a veteran club. They ended up blowing out the Texas Longhorns on Monday with a big win. Peyton Chatagnier out a few weeks. We hope that those hamstrings get well quickly. I mean, think about it. You hadn't played in a year. You come out of the gate. You got all this potential and buzz around you. And you're playing well and then, you get injured. So we'll see what happens this week with Ole Miss and Mississippi State. A lot of excitement around Bianco and Lamonis' club. Blake?
Oh, rightfully so. I think it'll be interesting to see, too, as Bianco mentioned, he said, we kind of don't have newcomers. I mean, you do, but like now this season already we're seeing that depth be challenged both for State and Ole Miss because you've got so many kids who have been in the program now 2 years but have never played or 3 years and have barely played. And so this will be an interesting season to see who does. Peyton Chatagnier is not the only player who will get injured.
Sure.
So who is for State and Ole Miss? Who's gonna step up? Who's gonna have that opportunity?
Well, we've got a deeper roster because of the players who stayed.
Exactly.
So that's a good point.
A little expanded roster this year. I think they get five more spots or something like that.
Which they needed. I don't know why they couldn't do more than that. But yes, you're right. Yeah. They did expand the roster.
So
see. They expanded it from 25 to 30?
I think that's correct.
Okay.
Yeah. So we'll see how that plays out.
I should ask Mike that.
We'll have him back on.
But it's early. Maybe 15 games from now we can say, what has the expanded roster meant to you and Lafferty and the club as far as moving pieces around going in the weekend.
And bullpen opportunity. Absolutely. How you manage your bullpen will be so key this season. Yeah.
Ole Miss 3-0, Mississippi State 2-1, Arkansas 3-0. Coming out of the College Baseball Showdown. We're going to jump back into some football. Some NFL quarterbacks and a little SEC football at 9:15. But coming up next, we're going to go out to San Diego. Welcome in our friend Matt Janella. 10 years with the Golf Channel. Just his thoughts on Tiger Woods and the accident. Thank God he survived. He looks like he's got a lot of rehab in front of him. Matt Janella will join us on the Shinerbach guest line. Oh, Shinerbach is super beer. Goodness gracious. Matt Janella coming up next on the Shinerbach guest line. The latest on Tiger Woods.